Look around, shush, and get gone. So first you have to understand the context of this training. Yes, the context is we try to avoid, we try to escape, and we try to de-escalate, but this is not possible. So now we have to jump to the physical. And the first with the most is usually the best, so you want to be first with action. What we call, you could call the battle plan. And the battle plan, you have a plan A and a plan B and a plan C. Let's say you want to use the plan A, and the plan A is I want to hit him, man's down. Then it did what's reasonable and necessary, and then I can go to the escape, yes? But plan A is designed to prevent further violence. I did what's reasonable, necessary, done. But plan A can go wrong. So let's say you hit somebody and he's not down or knocked out yet. There can be, for example, a transition. And a transition means he gives you distance. Now you don't want to wait for his response because he can give up or he can come forward now. So you need constant forward offensive pressure. Yes? So if he gives you a transition, you would try to attach him and beat him down. So this is what we call the beatdown, is what we call the plan B part. Let's say during this beatdown he's still standing, and now need plan C, and that's the, what we call the takedown and the finishing. Today we're mostly going to look at plan A and plan B. And another option is you deal with one and now his friend is coming. So before you start with plan A, that's the pre-anthem, so you hit first, there's a build-up. And in this build-up you have to get your adrenaline under control. You have to keep your mindset and you need to control your adrenaline effects. Yeah, you need to control your tunnel vision, your heavy breathing, your dry mouth, etc. So you want to use this buildup of adrenaline. It's boiling inside of you. You want to use it as a resource. And there's only one way to do this, and that's by attacking first. So one of my first altercations on the door, I felt the build up and then I exploded. Way too aggressive. I should regulate it more, but I feel instant relief when I did it. So learning moments for me. But as soon as you put the fight button on, you don't have to deal with the stress of the adrenaline anymore. So that's what we teach you here. Use this, utilize this adrenaline, yes? And that's why we use the aggression on a switch. Nobody is fearful when angry. You can only be in one emotional state at the same time. If you did this, you now want to continue to exploit your initiative by keep on attacking. So do we all understand the context of this training? We couldn't avoid, we couldn't escape. I now need to be physical with this. So he slides in, whoop, whoop, move. Now I slide in, whoop, whoop, move. Strikes. And a palm strike, if you can, grab a mango or grab a beer out of the fridge, you can make a palm strike. This is the part of the weapon you hit with. You get this in one line, and this is where you aim, on a ledge of bone. That's the good shit about a palm strike. Fist, that's why I lost me a knuckle. You have to aim more. So that's the principle of hard against soft, and this soft can be against hard. So use this part of the hand for a palm strike. Yes, get it straight, strong. This fingers is bonus if you can put one in the eye. You have 5 chances of this, but this is secondary. It's not what you aim for. You hit for the impact, and if the hand is gouging an eye, that's bonus. Yes? First, simple. Most ideal situation, you have all range of motion. So you want to have the arm stretched. So left, right, and this. So you want to hit left and right equal as hard. Yes? So just without thinking about, I want to be non-telegraphic, first the body mechanics. Boom, a twist, boom, a twist, yes? Aim through the target. So don't stop. If this is 0, this is 10, don't stop at 10. This should be 0 and 10 should be here. So this should be 5, so you really should. Bam, bam. For this, you work with the cross now. Simple, yes? You need aggression on the switch, because you need to deal with adrenaline. I'm not doing this. I'm doing as hard as you can with fucking intention. Why? Nobody's fearful when angry. You want to override your adrenaline. And let's say I drop somebody clinical with this guttural sound. Maybe his friend will stop because he is defeated on a psychological level. So one, you beat physically, and the other one on a psychological, you have 50% chance that this can happen. Also, if you force yourself to be guttural, you now need to breathe in again. This is the way to control your heart rate. This is the way you can control your adrenaline. Yes, if your heart rate goes too high, you lose cognitive thinking, you will go back to your limbic system, and you will end up with the intelligence of a dog. So you want to stay cognitive. That's the part of this, yes?
One!
Yes.
One!
More intention.
One!
Use this as emotional detox. If you have a shitty day, put it in your strikes right now.
One!
Yes.
Go! Go! Go!
This is a Jamie Miller's drill. Jamie is a brother from England. He's the UK hand instructor, solid instructor. You should look into him, really good stuff. And he's always brilliant with his pad feet and his way of striking and use restricted striking. Now the same, but we're gonna bring the target closer now. So now we have to work with the restricted striking, so body mechanics becomes more important. In real life, if this is my target, I will bam, bam, go to hammer fist, but purely for tool development, because I want to develop the tool of the palm strike, I'm going to stay with the palm strike. So this becomes close, and I get so look at my feet, it comes boom, boom. It's not only this, it's yes, so but closer now, so it's uncomfortable.
Closer.
So bumping first, you bump from here, yes? And then we change, boom, bump. So now you really need to twist, boom. So don't do this, don't slap, twist. So now it becomes body mechanics. So you bump him, get the pad in, try this. Bump. So try to
one, two, three, four, five, six.
Yes.
Two. Three.
Good job! Give me, fucking hell. He doesn't give me another choice. Yes, so I need to hit him first. If I could escape, I would escape. But this is the situation I cannot, and he gives me pre-threat cue behavior. He's grimacing, he's giving a shift in body weight, he's reaching for something, he is looking away, looking around, maybe for his friends or CCTV or witnesses, and now there's a possibility he strikes. So you want to be first. Yes, so first, the ideal situation. Plan A, you need to hit him first. If he's down to the floor, you did what's reasonable and necessary. There is no need for more violence. So it can be as clinical as this. You get a conversation. For now, we leave the role play out. First, we have to start. Cold clinical from this position. Ouch! And then man is down. It's enough. So what I try to do is grab him for an attachment. I need to attach him because I want to, if I hit him for real, boom, I'm going to grab him. So if I knock him out, I control his descent. Because I want to defend myself, I don't want to kill him doing it. Another reason can be why I attach is because I want to create a collision effect. Another reason can be there's a friend coming so I can shield with him. Another reason can be it's a sensory antenna. I feel when he's slumping body weight or when he's still combative. So I need to keep on hitting him. I just hit and grab. Yes, just grab the arm. When he's falling down, I'm stepping to the side. I want to control his descent. Yes? This is first. Don't step in the middle because he will pull you against him. Try this first, yes? You are a predator, yes? You wanna... Oh fuck, I need to grab him. But first, the shot. Don't do it simultaneously because this will get the impact power out. So hit, grab. Hit, grab. Yes? And if there's nothing to grab, he's on the floor already, you at least tried. Yes? Ready? Good job. Step to the side. Step with it. Yes. Change pads. During this plan A, you want to hit him, knock him down, knock him out. Or knock him back maybe. That it's so much distance that you can run. But for this situation now, we're going to show you if plan A fails. As soon as I'm hitting him and there's a need for a transition, he makes a transition, but he's not going down yet. I need to follow up. This is going to be my B plan. I need to beat him down now. So for this drill, we stay with the palm strikes just for the sake of learning how to palm strike from different angles. But also, this can literally be the only tool you need. He's gonna, when I first hit him from this position, bam, an attachment. I don't have an attachment right now. And then now need to recognize this transition. Need to hit him again, hit him again, hit him again, until man is down.
Ready, go!
Good job. Nice. Yes. So, if you get people that like to box, they always have a discussion. They say like, yeah, I would rather punch. It's all good. A palm or a punch is for me the same. But a punching requires more aiming. Especially under stress, this is difficult. This is how I lost, for example, myself, a knuckle. But you can also, if you want to hit and grab, then you can punch, punch, punch again. It's the same dynamic. We're training Blitzkrieg, a preemptive and offensive campaign designed to totally overwhelm the enemy before any retaliation or recovery is possible. I want constant forward offensive pressure. My nose over my toes, constantly, until man is down. Because he made me do it, I cannot avoid, I cannot escape, I could not de-escalate. He thought you were a victim, he victim selected you, but he thought wrong. Now you are the predator. So we have a change in dynamic. Yes? Before we're gonna look into what can happen with multiple subjects, I wanna introduce you to the principle of a stop hit. Again, you wanna be the first with action, yes? And that's the essence of being preemptive, be the first. But if he's coming like this with bad intention in his face with a really fast pace forward, it's not really preemption from your side because he's already there on a psychological level. So he's already preparing to hit you for what reason soever. As soon as I see him coming forward, I would directly give him this structure. So in this split second, again, maybe I had a problem with him before, or maybe I see so much bad intention that it gives me really uncomfortable feet and just hit him. So you need confidence for that and good training. But what you now get is what we call a stop hit. He's coming forward, so you get a collision effect, like two cars crashing into each other. So instead of freezing, turning around and waiting for him, I'm gonna step into his forward pressure from this position. And this is probably what you will get if it's 100%. Yes. Context. Let's say we're fighting multiple subjects. If I know that, for example, Dan and Thomas are with each other and next to each other, I would not fight a fight like this. I would not blitz through him and then wait for him. Then I probably would do something else, would grab him, get them in a line, knee him, snatch him, so I deal with him first and now I deal with him. But let's say because of the interview, he was aggressive in your fucking face and now you had to deal with one of the side effects of adrenaline, tunnel vision, and he's intimidating you and he gave you a reason that you now need to blitz him. Yeah, for this, for example, I could do blitz him. And now, because I'm training, I'm not focusing on him anymore. I look for the secondary threat. And let's say I missed his fucking friend and he is all of a sudden running towards me because I just beat up his friend. He's coming forward, I can give him this drop step, or the stop hit. So, this is from the idea that I missed his friend. It can be everywhere, on the street, can be in the bar, but all of a sudden, his friend is coming. So I wanna simulate this. He gave me reason to blitz him, because he gave me a pre-tech cue, maybe you reach for a weapon, and now we hit him first and keep on hitting him. He's gonna surprise me with an attack forward. I'll just show you that with one tool, palm strike, you can blitz through a subject, and when his friend is coming, maybe he can use the concept of a stop hit, so the collision effect. So it can be as clinical as this. He gives you a reason from this, look around, and get gone. Look around, yes, man down, good job. Yes.
press and run, escape.
Good.